I'm Justin Chang for the Los Angeles Times, and this is my list of the 10 best films of 2016. At number 10 is Certain Women, Kelly Reichardt's quietly heartbreaking triptych of stories about four different women living in rural Montana. The performances by Laura Dern, Michelle Williams, and Kristen Stewart are superbly understated, but it's Lily Gladstone, the newcomer in the cast, who stands in a class by herself. At number 9 on my list is Manchester by the Sea, a scaldingly emotional and sometimes startlingly funny portrait of a Massachusetts man, played by Casey Affleck in one of the year's best performances, coming to terms with an unthinkable tragedy. After You Can Count on Me and Margaret, the film confirms the writer-director Kenneth Lonergan as one of the most distinctive voices on the American independent scene. Number 8 is I Am Not Your Negro, a brilliant documentary from the Haitian filmmaker Raoul Peck. Sifting through the words of the late writer and activist James Baldwin, combined with superb archival footage and voiceover readings by Samuel L. Jackson, this is a vivid and emotionally penetrating essay on the struggle for black justice in this country, from the civil rights era to the present. At number 7, we have Patterson, Jim Jarmusch's gentle and beguiling film about several days in the life of a bus driver and amateur poet, beautifully played by Adam Driver. The movie looks deceptively simple, but scene after scene, its intricate and imaginative construction serves as a reminder that still waters run deep. Number 6 is My Golden Days, a youthful love story directed by the great French filmmaker Arnaud Desplechin, and a prequel of sorts to his 1993 film My Sex Life, or How I Got Into an Argument. Quentin Dolmer and Lou Roy Le Collinet give sensational breakout performances, and the movie has the ardent romanticism and formal ingenuity of Desplechin's best work. At number 5, we have another riff on a 90s classic, Everybody Wants Some, a spiritual sequel to Richard Linklater's seminal high school comedy, Dazed and Confused. And yet this gloriously funny and deeply felt flashback to Linklater's 80s college days works beautifully on its own. At number 4 on my list is Ezra Edelman's galvanizing, nearly 8-hour documentary, O.J. Made in America, which was produced for ESPN, but also shown in theaters. Whichever way you see it, this epic consideration of race, class, sports, and celebrity in American life is a monumental achievement. At number 3 on my list is Toni Erdmann, an almost indescribable comedy from the German filmmaker Marinade. It stars Sandra Hüller as an uptight businesswoman and Peter Simonischek as her deadpan clown of a father who will do anything and everything to bring a little joy to her life. What transpires over this movie's nearly 3-hour running time is moving and funny, even as it defies every expectation. My second favorite film of the year is Moonlight, Barry Jenkins' exquisitely tender and affecting portrait of a young black gay man's coming of age in Miami. He's played in 3 parts by the actors Alex R. Hibbert, Ashton Sanders, and Trevante Rhodes. Believe the hype on this one. This movie is a landmark achievement, lyrical and true and full of feeling. And finally, my number 1 movie of the year is Silence, Martin Scorsese's wrenching adaptation of Shusaku Endo's novel about Portuguese priests in 17th century feudal Japan. Contemplating the kinds of questions about faith, sacrifice, and the absence of God with a seriousness and rigor worthy of Bresson and Bergman, this is a film of masterful restraint and one of the pinnacles of Scorsese's career. And that concludes my top 10 films of 2016. I'm Justin Chang for the Los Angeles Times.